Ross Greenwood is with me now. And Ross, the Treasurer and the Prime Minister seem to have been softening us up for some pretty bad news.
That's what it seems like. But it's also a pretty strong message from the Prime Minister and also the Treasurer to the Reserve Bank Board that they should stay the course regardless of whether this inflation rate appears higher than expected. The real problem is that if this inflation rate does come in as expected, and you can see the headline rate for the quarter, 1%, and for the year through 3.9%. But that is the headline. And the problem is that inflation is not going down as was broadly expected. It's going up. And so with higher inflation rate, that puts pressure on the Reserve Bank. The so-called narrow path that they talk about is the important part about this. If you have a look at the money markets right now, while the rest of the world right now is suggesting that there will be an interest rate cut, here in Australia, there is forecast that interest rates will rise. And so money markets right now have got the suggestion of around a 20% chance of an interest rate rise when the Reserve Bank meets next week. It hasn't come up there, but that's what it is right now. But the important thing about this, Laura, is right now the government is basically girding itself, but also the community, for the prospect of this higher inflation rate and therefore the prospect of higher interest rates.
If it is high as expected, does the RBA have any other choice than to raise rates?
It really does. It has the choice of doing nothing. But the danger of doing that is that inflation becomes baked in. It becomes baked into your insurance premiums. It becomes baked into rents. It becomes baked into wages. And the fact of the matter is, the longer it goes on, the harder it is to get out. And the only way to get it out is to raise interest rates. So the fact is, there's an argument that perhaps Australia didn't go hard enough, early enough. But the fact is here that you now see that we've had these 4.35% interest rates compared with the rest of the world, where they went higher, but it was expected that really our household sector with variable mortgages would be affected by these higher rates, that this would be enough. But it seems now that they are resilient. People have got jobs, people are still consuming, and they have absorbed these interest rate rises better than perhaps the Reserve Bank and the government expected they would.
Well, the budget, and Jim Chalmers told us at the time that inflation would come down. He had it there in the figures, black and white, even if it was done artificially through these household measures. Essentially, after that, we heard from the RBA governor saying that essentially the RBA board would probably look through those.
Yes.
They have.
And that's precisely what will happen here. So the key rate I showed you earlier was the headline rate. But what I also want to show you here is the underlying rate. And the trim mean, or the underlying rate, strips out the one-off factors, such as the cost of living relief that the government would hand out. Remember, that was $300 per household for your energy bills, which means that energy bills become cheaper, which takes it off the headline rate of inflation. But this is really what the headline, the underlying rate, trim mean, is expected to be. And look at that, 4%. Remember, the guide for the Reserve Bank is to keep inflation between 2% and 3%. And the fact is, this is the narrow path. This is where it becomes more difficult for the Reserve Bank. So if inflation is going up and not showing signs of coming down, it has got little choice but to act at that time.
What happened, Ross? Why is the rest of the world looking at cuts and we're still looking at more increases?
Well, you could argue that really, in hindsight, misjudgments were made about the strength of Australian consumers and the strength of Australia's economy. Because do bear in mind that the consumer and our spending takes up at least 50% of our economy. So let's have a look at inflation right now around the world. Here's Australia at 3.6, but likely after today to be at 4%. New Zealand went harder with interest rates stronger, did send their economy into recession, but now they're looking at interest rate cuts. The same thing in the US. We'll see decisions from the US Federal Reserve this week. We'll see a decision on interest rates from the Bank of England this week. Canada, look at its inflation rate. It went harder for longer. It's had two consecutive interest rate cuts in the past 2 months. But then Australia's inflation rate is higher and seems to be going higher still. The danger now is that inflation is baked into our economy as compared with some of those other countries that took stronger measures. And as a result, now we've still got a bit of pain on the interest rate front ahead of us from here. So there's the unemployment rate as well. You can see that, and it's still nudging along the bottom. And that was the argument, to try and hang on to jobs. And it's a noble thing to have done. But the fact is that this experiment of trying to keep all the jobs while bringing down inflation, unfortunately, that hasn't happened in any developed economy in the world so far.
Yeah, it's not working. Ross, thanks so much for the update. We look forward to talking to you next hour, and of course your coverage at 11:30 when these numbers do drop.